One of the rules of this trip is don't run out of water or you die, so we kind of need water right now. Coyote Gulch, kind of right where it dumps into the Escalante River. Nothing to it. It'd be kind of funny if I just got lodged in here. So, you know what? I think we should take the packs off and drop them. Gonna take the high route here. Yeah, it's easier. I mean, I can just get down here. both your tent, my tent and your tent, and the arch. Yeah, that's gonna be it. Looking down on the Escalante River. We'll be crossing that in the morning.
Yeah, you just have trouble gauging stuff like that, distances.
Good morning, Joey. What day is it? What day is it?
It's day two.
How are you feeling?
It's a little chilly.
Yep.
But I feel great. Excited. It's going to be another great day.
What do you think of this campsite?
It's a pretty awesome camping spot.
Yep.
It's hard to beat, actually. Just completely surrounded by walls. The arches back there. Looking down on the Escalante River over here. Looking down on Coyote Gulch. Pretty cool. And the stars were freaking awesome last night. What do you call that thing? The Milky Way was right over the top of us. I mean, we could see that before the sun was even gone, pretty much. We could still see the sunlight lighting up the Milky Way. That's how awesome the stars are out here.
Yeah, amazing. What's the plan for today?
The plan for today is we're going to be... First, we got to drop down in the Escalante River. We're going to cross it. We're gonna go up the canyon a little bit, and we're gonna hit Stevens Canyon, and we're gonna start going up Stevens Canyon, which we're gonna spend a couple days in. And the lower part of Stevens Canyon, it's gonna be kind of high walls and very narrow, very brushy in there. So we're gonna have some bushwhacking, which hopefully isn't too bad because it's late in the year. Some poison ivy in there, which is hopefully dead, but there's a little thing called Poison Ivy Hill that we gotta get up over. And we're gonna see like this little thing called the grotto. It's like a little pool of water and an arch, and gonna do some climbing, and we'll get up to up in Stevens Canyon. We're gonna be up on some benches kind of just like this, surrounded by all these little peaks and fins and walls, and have another awesome camp.
Sweet, thank you.
So we've reached the Escalante River, and now we gotta cross, and someone's gotta be a guinea pig and go see what it's about. So I'm gonna go in first. Changes every year, you know, kind of with the floods, so sometimes it's pretty easy to cross in here, and then sometimes there can be really deep holes. Don't really know. Plus there's quicksand in here, so just kind of gotta go out there and see what happens. I was just saying you can camp right here. I like camping down here. I've never seen it so, like all this brush underneath here, I don't ever remember seeing it this brushy actually. Usually this is all just sand. It changes all the time, but it's just interesting to see like different changes for me over 6 years of kind of being in this place. That's something actually the guy told me I ran into the other day that has spent a lifetime down here. He was telling me, I asked him what the big difference was. He said the brush. There's way more brush now than there used to be everywhere in southern Utah. The tamarisk, the Russian olive plants, I think.
How was that, Joey?
It's too deep in there. Like, you can cross, but it's gonna be chest deep because the angle of the rock. You can't step on it, it's covered, it's slick, you slide down. Swimmer. Your shoes, better than mine. Slide or slide in there.
What do you think of this, Joey?
I just think it's cool. It's like, this is definitely a lot of sand in here.
Yep.
Sun and warm back up. Hold up.
That was
starting to just make a mental note of that, because we don't know how much more we're going to see the rest of the way. And this is much drier. Like every other time that I've been in here, it's usually all running water in here. So this is the first water we've really seen that's something we could use. So we just got to pay attention.
Yep. Yeah, the first time I ever looked at the map of Escalante, and they have the river mile on there, I was just like, oh, it's only 70 miles. I can probably pull that off in like 4 days. And no, there's no way that's gonna happen.
Man, yeah, these shoes suck. See exactly what you're saying.
Yeah.
I have to put pressure on my shoes, and then
once you get on that ledge, it's good.
Slide.
Once you get on the ledge below your leg there, that's a good one.
Sweet.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I could just jump down there, huh?
It's a little bit far. Okay.
You good?
Yep.
What you mean?
Yep. It's a bit higher than it looks.
Higher than it looked.
Yeah. Just jump far so you're yeah. Sweet.
back for some rum?
Yep, for sure. So Joey, why are you filling all that water?
Because this is probably the last water source we're gonna see for a while, and one of the rules of this trip is don't run out of water or you die, so we kinda need water right now.
How's your pack feeling? How much water are you carrying?
Yeah, I got between 6 and 7 liters on me.
Nice. That's good for a good climb. Yeah.
The golden tones. The golden domes and autumn tones.
Oh.
why I want to go see what Georgie's camp is like, because it's going to be the same thing.
This is absolutely fantastic. Beautiful.
Pretty cool rock.
Yeah. What do you think of this, Joey?
Pretty sweet.
Is there any exposure?
No, you just stay up against the wall.
Whatever you do, don't go up.
I'm not going, I'm going back. Holy shit. Well, I mean, you can do it. You can probably do it, but there's going to be some moves up there that over exposure like this. I mean, I'm stoned. I'm not doing that right now.
Yeah, buddy. I think so.
Like behind you. Okay.
How do you feel about finding water, Joey?
Oh, I didn't find water. Jarl did, but this is awesome. We're at the top of a cliff, so about 6,700 feet above sea level. Awesome views all the way around. You know, it wasn't hard walking to get over here, but just slow walking. Kind of had to work our way through the tops of several canyons, and Jarl found water. It's just great news. The trip goes on, and I think we're going to camp here, because why not? We have the time. We're slow playing this. Doesn't get better than this. We have perfect weather. So we're going to sit on the top of the cliff and have a camp. Gangster, Jarl. It's total gangster.
It is.